Nils Nikolaisen Astrup was born in 1843 in Norway. At the age of 18, he went to study law at the Royal Frederick University in Christiania, now Oslo, graduating cum laude 6 years later. For the next 3 years, he followed in his father's footsteps as an assistant judge. Then, in 1870, he returned to university to study theology. During this time, in 1872, he married Anna Katharina Thurman, herself also well-educated with a particular talent as a painter. Together, they had 9 children, only 5 of whom survived to adulthood, as well as a foster son, Carl Dorvig. Nils taught at a Lutheran boarding school while studying and graduated cum laude with a theology degree in 1877. Thereafter, he was a parish priest in Norddal until 1883. In 1882, Bishop Schroeder, the leader of the Norwegian Lutheran mission in Zululand, South Africa, died, and a call went out for a successor. Nils felt called to replace him, and together with his wife and 5 children, plus their 16-year-old foster son, sailed to South Africa in 1883 on the Warwick Castle, landing first at Cape Town before continuing to Durban. Pastor Astrup wrote, "Durban appears to be a rapidly growing city with streets which are longer and more civilized than those of Cape Town. The city is very attractively situated on a large bay. In the middle of the streets grow all the South's trees, fruits, and flowers." He continued, "If death did not exist, the worldly, fallen human race would soon forget about heaven here. As it is, people still do so far too often." The Astrups travelled by rail over the Umgeni River and past seemingly endless undulating fields of sugarcane to Verulam, about 30 kilometres north of Durban. The next part of the journey to the mission station at Untunjumbili was by ox wagon. Pastor Astrup wrote, "Each wagon had a tent of canvas and was drawn by 10 oxen, 5 yokes and 1 iron chain but no reins, steered by a small boy in a blue shirt in front of the first yoke, together with an adult driver with a whip which could crack out about 7 meters and land right where it was needed." The journey from Durban to the mission station took 4 days. Today, the trip is under 2.5 hours by car. Missionary work in those days was carried out under difficult conditions, to say the least. In 1885, the Astrups had twins, but they both died of malnutrition in infancy because a shipment of powdered milk failed to arrive. Early on, Nils Astrup began to think about carrying the gospel further north, and he started to plan an exploratory journey through Swaziland, the present-day Mswatini, to Umgaza in what is now part of Mozambique. It was in 1889 that he undertook this return trek of at least 1,500 kilometers as far as the Limpopo River in mostly rough, inhospitable terrain, together with Carl Dorvig and a party of Zulu bearers. It was to be an epic test of his leadership, determination and endurance, one which he courageously saw to completion. After the turn of the century, Nils Astrup returned to Norway for a short time. This was to be his only trip back to Europe in 36 years as a missionary. Whilst there, he was made a Knight of the Order of St. Olaf for remarkable accomplishments on behalf of the country and humanity, and ordained a missionary bishop in Trondheim in 1902. Thereafter, Bishop Astrup returned to Untunjumbili. He gave his home there the name El Seteli, meaning in Hebrew, "God is my refuge." It was there that he and his wife, children and brother continued to serve energetically in the cause of the gospel. Researcher Frederick Hale writes, "So profound was his influence and that of his children that for decades their organization was colloquially known in some circles both in Norway and the Union of South Africa as the Astrup Mission." Bishop Nils Astrup died at El Seteli on the 18th of March 1919 and was buried in the churchyard at Untunjumbili. Known by the Zulus by the praise name Lion of the Great Forest, Bishop Astrup was a man whose motives led him to exchange material gain and comfort for hardship, danger, and sometimes personal tragedy in order to bring both eternal and present well-being to a people in a far-off and undeveloped part of the world. I leave the last word in this brief account to a Zulu chief who, at Bishop Astrup's funeral, gave what to me is the ultimate compliment, saying, "When Umfundisi comes to a hard place, he just says, 'In Jesus' name,' and goes ahead."